It's called Leads Online, a unique national database that's helping 4,000 law enforcement agencies in all 50 states. It can track down stolen property and the thieves who pawn the loot. KXAN's David Scott shows us how Travis County detectives use Leads Online to help them catch a sticky-fingered housekeeper who has since confessed to quite the crime spree.
Travis County detectives have been investigating a series of jewelry thefts at homes for more than a year now, and they used a unique computer database. And what they found was one common link to all the thefts, a house cleaner named Dina Lombardo. Dina Lombardo has an extensive criminal past and was, in fact, on parole for a prior theft when she got nailed again. Deputies say she robbed homes in the Lakeway, Bee Cave area, hitting perhaps a dozen or more for approximately $80,000 in jewelry.
Well, she didn't take anything that was silver or platinum. It was all yellow gold and diamonds, rings, necklaces, pendants, earrings, something small that she could put into a pocket.
They say Lombardo took the hot goodies to pawn shops near her East Austin apartment. They were able to track her thanks to Leads Online, which had records of all her pawn transactions.
It's actually a huge tool to have at our disposal. We may not have a suspect. We don't know the first thing about who it was that took it. We can find who pawned it because you have to show a Texas ID in Texas or a state issued ID to be able to pawn your item. And the pawn transaction documents the serial number, what type of item it was, and who it was that pawned that item. Well, now I've got somebody to go and look at.
Leads Online not only finds the paper trail, but in a fraction of the time.
If I were to try and pull pawn slips from every transaction, it would just take me a phenomenal amount of time to go through every one of those different pawn slips and read the same description over and over and over and look for a serial number.
In Dina Lombardo's case, the system tracked down the stolen goods and her rather unusual pattern of behavior.
She had nearly 100 pawn transactions in a year. That's not consistent with somebody who's going down and getting a payday loan until paycheck comes in and just to cover the bills.
Dina Lombardo now sits in the Travis County Jail. Because she had been out on parole for a prior theft conviction, her bond has been revoked and she'll remain behind bars for quite some time. In Western Travis County, David Scott, KXAN News.